His father's a hockey legend, the famous Golden Jet. And now Brett Hull skates out of his father's shadow to become a hockey hero.
When Brett Hull emerged as one of the NHL's best goal scorers in the 1990s, it was tempting to compare him to his fleet-footed father, Bobby, the Golden Jet, one of the game's all-time greats. But while Bobby was a teenage prodigy, Brett wasn't initially considered good enough to make it to the NHL.
I was a late bloomer. People would say, "You're Bobby Hull's son. I thought you'd be better." I go, "Well, I'm not Bobby Hull. I'm Brett Hull."
And now breaking in Brett Hull. The shot. Well, he scores!
Passed over by Canada's top junior teams, Hull attended the University of Minnesota Duluth, where he became one of college hockey's most feared scorers, in part because of advice from his famous dad.
I wasn't a really great skater, so I shot. My dad, he goes, "You can't score goals with just slap shots. You need to develop that wrist shot." And so then I worked on that, and all of a sudden, it was almost divine intervention. When I would go on the ice, I knew where to go and what to do to score.
Shoot, score!
Drafted in the sixth round by the Calgary Flames in 1984, Hull was traded to St. Louis in March of 1988. He tallied an impressive 41 goals in his first full season with the Blues, but the man behind the bench thought he was capable of even more.
I was expecting a big pat on the back. Coach Brian Sutter berated me. He said, "You're lazy, you have no idea how good you are or what you can be." I thought, wow, if he thinks that I'm that good, I'm gonna go and see if he's really right.
Oates gives it in front to Hull, a shoot, he scores! And Hull becomes only the fifth player in NHL history to score 50 goals in 50 games.
After improving his conditioning and skating, Hull went on a tear, leading the league in goal scoring for three straight seasons, including an astonishing 86 in 1990-91, third best all time, and the highest total by anyone not named Wayne Gretzky. He won the Hart Trophy that season as league MVP.
He was very clever to get in a position to shoot the puck, and man, could he shoot the puck.
He was one of the top two or three pure goal scorers in the history of the National Hockey League.
Hull got it. Shot. Score!
He didn't need much time and space to get that shot away.
All round, I would say the best shot ever. Just speed, accuracy, and his ability to get it off.
Hull's biggest goal would come for Dallas, where he signed in 1998. It was triple overtime in Game 6 of the 1999 Stanley Cup Final. Hull hoisted the cup again 3 years later as a member of the Detroit Red Wings, and in 2009 took his place in the Hockey Hall of Fame alongside his father.
I got as much enjoyment out of watching him play as I did playing the 15 years that I had. Nobody could score goals in so many different ways as Brett Hull.
Brett Hull's 741 career goals ranks fourth all time, and like his dad, he produced five seasons of 50 or more goals.
My dad cast a pretty big shadow, and all I wanted to do was stand halfway into his, yet cast my own. So we made twice as big a shadow, and it worked out very well for me.